Wednesday night stand-up, the students of Stoneman Douglas demand action, a two-hour town hall organized and televised by CNN, put Senator Marco Rubio in the proverbial hot seat. Like many Republicans, he's received substantial NRA support over the years, and like many Republicans, he's said that gun restrictions wouldn't be a cure to prevent mass shooting. At the town hall, Rubio said he supports universal background checks, raising the minimum age to purchase guns to 21, and banning bump stocks that allow rifles to fire more rapidly. But the audience wasn't impressed. Rubio was confronted by Stoneman Douglas Jr. Cameron Caskey about accepting donations from the National Rifle Association.
You can ask that question, and I can tell you that people buy into my agenda. I will answer any questions you guys have about any policy.
Right now, guys, be quiet. You know.
And I just think that ultimately that is not our goal here. Our goal here is to move forward.
Wait, so hold on. In the name of 17 people, you cannot ask the NRA to keep their money out of your campaign.
I think in the name of 17 people, I can pledge to you that I will support any law that will prevent a killer like this.
No, but I'm talking NRA money.
No, because...
Matter of fact, guys, I bet we can get people in here to give you exactly as much money as the NRA would have.
But it's not. I understand. And you're right.
The senator also had a back and forth with U.S. Representative Ted Deutch, who represents Parkland and wants a ban on assault weapons. Rubio wasn't the only one who got a hostile reaction from South Floridians. Dana Loesch, national spokeswoman for the National Rifle Association, also received multiple jeers from the audience during her appearance on stage. Loesch was challenged by Emma Gonzalez, a Stoneman Douglas student who has been an outspoken advocate for gun control, Broward Sheriff Scott Israel, and Diane Woke Rogers, a teacher who survived the shooting.